in its entirety. We need the same battery center. If we send the battery checks to Europe, number 1 to 50, we expect number 1 to 50 to be returned to the controller's office with all the documentation, because we have to account for every check.
So moving forward, you won't be sending any more checks in
the system. Well, unless I can get the assurance that they're going to be in a safe place. Unless I'm sure that, okay, whoever is seeing these checks are supposed to be seeing these checks and the documentation. Some of that documentation has vendors' EIN numbers, okay? They have the addresses, they have the telephone numbers, they have, some may have social security numbers with the four last digits redacted. But unless I can get some assurance that they are safe and secure, I will stop that process right now. But the people's business must go on.
And my final question is, are these people that the mayor hires confused with who these people are being referred to, the strangers, to see?
Well, there was a letter sent out by the city clerk's office, and I think we've all seen that letter, in which an individual was observed sitting at a desk. That person is not an employee of the city. That person should not have access to a computer in the city. That person should not be able to go into our MULIS system and look at documents. So those things we're concerned about. And I'm sure there are people around City Hall who've had access to pertinent information that they should not have access to. You know, and we're concerned about that.
What reason do you have to believe that these are the people that might be responsible for the signatures?
I never said those are the people who are responsible. I don't know.
But you said you wanted them investigated.
Well, what I would do is investigate where these checks are. Where are the checks? Who's seen these checks? Who has photocopied these checks? Because some checks were photocopied. I have copies of checks that were sent to my office. The original was not returned to my office, but a copy of that check was returned to my office, which means they were photocopied. Who has access to those documents?
Has this ever happened before where checks have been forged on the scene?
This happened about 8 to 10 years ago when it was through Urban Renewal Office. It was never on our level with accounts payable checks or payroll checks.
So in your opinion, does the mayor have any accountability in this?
Can you explain to us what MUNIS is and if you have the ability to look at check numbers in the MUNIS system?
MUNIS is our software package, right? Because we did find out that someone had access.
That's my next question. If you have access to this unauthorized individual, can that individual look in MUNIS and see the sequence numbers of checks paid out?
I'm not 100% sure if they can, for the accounts payable checks.
And how would that individual get access to MUNIS? Obviously, you got to have passcodes, and if you're not an employee.
That would have been access given by the management service division.
Do we have a present commissioner of management services?
No, not to my knowledge.
No, I'm saying, I think that's
another
question.
Yes.
Thank you.
One final. So does the council support the controller in her decision to change the check process in light of this forgery?
So I'd like to go back to the charter as often as I